Now, she was the winner of the very first season of MasterChef Australia, and today Julie Goodwin joins us from her test kitchen with a really special recipe. Julie Goodwin, it's always a pleasure seeing you. We're going to try to follow along with you in the studio. What are we making today?
Excellent. This is a really easy midweek dish. It's called pasta boscaiola, or if I'm trying to get my kids enthused about it, I tell them it's creamy bacon pasta and everyone's happy then. So what I need you, if you're going to cook along with me, you've got to kind of get a little wriggle on.
Yep.
So first of all, we're going to cut up some bacon just into little pieces, little strips.
Strips.
And when you're shopping for bacon, it's always handy to look, well, it's best to look for the Australian. So look for the level that says it's Australian bacon.
Mm-hmm. How come I don't get the knife? Not to be trusted, Kerri-Anne. And chuck it in the pan?
Straight into a hot pan, so have your pan on.
Yep.
You don't need to put oil in for this because bacon generally has enough fat to sort of render out and cook itself. So that's 3 rashers of bacon.
Yep.
And then I'm just going to turn the board over,
grab
a fresh knife because I'm done cutting meat. So just for food safety.
That's contamination.
Place my mushrooms on a fresh board.
Yeah, can I put the pasta in because we want to get on with it? How much do I put in? I've got a whole thing here.
Is your water boiling rapidly, Kerri-Anne, with salt in it?
Salt.
So you need your water boiling rapidly.
Have I put salt in it?
Salt. Yep.
There you go.
That's pepper.
Yeah, it's got to be salt. It's really, really important.
And how much salt?
Just a good handful, tablespoon or so.
Okay.
It should be salty like the sea. Salty like the sea, pasta water.
Okay, got all that in. And do I put the whole bag of pasta in? Or feta?
It's a 375-gram bag of fettuccine, but you pop it all in.
300.
If it's 500, you can leave a handful out and have that another day.
Is that 375 grams?
375. Well.
How many blondes does it take to boil pasta? That's 500, so okay, maybe like that much.
Yeah,
just 2/3. About 3/4 of that.
There we go.
Exactly 3/4 of that.
Okay.
Okey-dokey.
Yep.
So your bacon should be sautéing away.
Yep.
And you're going to slice up those mushrooms and pop those in as well.
Now,
so
can
once
I just
the bacon's rendered a little bit of fat.
Look, we aren't going to eat this. This is just a test only, so please excuse the use of the
She may not be going to eat it.
Well, look, you're going to have to take your chances, Kat, because I've just cross-contaminated.
Taking bigger chances than this show.
I'll be serving this for dinner tonight to my family, so...
Okay.
Oh, good.
Now, can I just mess this around while you're talking? So what do we do? So
sauté the bacon.
Sarah's... doing the mushies?
Yep, that's right. So let the bacon cook away over a nice high heat. Render a bit of fat.
So do we let the bacon crisp up, Julie, or do we just let it kind of brown up a little?
Julie, it's sort of going golden. It's released a bit of fat.
Yep.
And then in with your mushrooms once you've got a bit of fat to cook those in, and the garlic as well.
Ooh. Is pea the highest? It is. Pea is the highest. Sorry, I haven't used this oven before.
Oh, okay.
Now here's gas? Yep, you go.
If it's gas, you can look at the flame and the bigger
no,
the flame.
No, it's not gas, it's one of those flat black things.
Convection. We have garlic in a tube, is that okay?
Sarah.
I know. As I said, look.
You can do it today, but next time, chop
next time,
fresh.
The proper way.
It tastes a lot better.
Julie, how do you peel your garlic? It is so annoying to get one clove and pulling it off. That's really annoying. Is there
crush
an easier
first.
Way?
You crush it first.
So
well,
you crush
if, you
it
grab, first. If you grab your clove and give it a bit of a whack with a knife, I've got my son here doing the camera work. Bring your camera over and I'll show you.
Okay.
So you've got a clove of garlic, give it a whack. And then the skin comes off nice and easy.
Oh, okay.
I've got an even better question. How do you get that smell of garlic off your fingers after you've been cutting and cooking with it? Seems to hang around for days.
It's a bar of stainless steel that you can use, but I just walk around enjoying
you love
the smell.
Yeah, it is pretty
imagine
nice.
Imagine my next Italian
it's
meal.
The new Chanel fragrance, Chanel Galecco.
Galecco.
That's right.
Okay, so we're doing pretty well here.
Yeah. What have you got the oil for?
Okay, so once that's cooking away, and you generally give it a couple more minutes than this so that your mushies go a bit, little bit brown. You're going to sprinkle on, you should have some corn flour there, just a yep. little tablespoon of corn flour. Sprinkle that over. Then yeah. you've got half a cup of white wine. Now, if you don't want to use wine, you can
let an expert do this. Really? Really? You're going to go there? Half a cup. Half a cup.
Yeah. Kat likes to cook with wine and sometimes she even adds it to the food.
Yeah.
Okay, so we've got the wine.
Mm.
So you pour that over and stir it to mix it.
See, I knew how to do that.
Good girl. Well, that smells good.
And then we're going to add the cream. Ooh. And I'll get Jo to bring this camera over. My beautiful filmmaking son, he is. Gosh, that smells so good.
Ooh, okay.
Pour in the cream.
Yum.
And you're going to let that reduce for a few minutes just so it thickens up.
Mm.
And then right at the very, very end, we're going to throw in some shallots that we'll chop.
Yep, we've done that. These are pre-chopped.
We'll chop those up. Oh, yours are pre-chopped. Oh, you're ahead of me now.
Oh, yeah.
And once the fettuccine's cooked, I'll show you a little bit after this how to pop that fettuccine in and how to serve this up as a beautiful Italian meal.
Well, Carrie-Anne and I have been cooking up a storm with MasterChef's Julie Goodwin. It is time for the big reveal.
Sorry,
Julie. Dig has actually never seen Carrie-Anne in the kitchen before.
He's never seen this look before.
He's alarmed.
Yeah, he says, what are you doing there, Mum?
My egg barking in the middle of things.
Yeah.
Oh, beautiful. So that's been bubbling away. And
yep.
I'm about to finish it off. It had a little taste. It doesn't need salt. So the bacon was salty enough for this.
Okay.
So I'm just going to pop in, before I turn off the heat, the shallots, or spring onions, as they are called, south of the border. And then straight out of the pan, straight out of the pot, into the pan.
Oh, so I take I'm taking out...
The pasta, yep.
Oh, okay. Let it drain just a little.
Well, you just hold it up with your tongs, and it doesn't matter if a little bit of the water comes in because it's beautiful, starchy water,
mm-hmm.
and that'll help your sauce to stick to the pasta.
Yeah, okay.
And then you're going to flip it around. You can toss it if you've got a pan with one big handle, but I've got a giant one with two.
Yeah, if we take it off the top, it stops cooking, so we can't do that. We're just going to give it a good mix. A good stir.
Julie, I've got to tell you, trying to keep a retriever out of the kitchen when there's food, believe you me, his life is lived by food. Number one, cuddles next.
Aww.
The way I have to serve is the middle of the table with the salads or whatever accompaniments you've got going on.
Again, why do we have the oil?
Why do we have which?
Olive oil.
Have we used that? It was just on for show.
Pop in a bit of oil to sort of start it off.
Oh, okay.
But that bacon that I have is beautiful and fatty.
Okay.
So, onto the dish here, and then beautiful.
And we've got some parmesan, which we'll put on last.
If you use bottled garlic, maybe you use that horrible powdered parmesan, fresh parmesan over the top.
That's pack of stuff we've got too.
Even I use grande parmigiana. Yum.
And there you go. That's your dinner done.
I want to have a go.
How good is that? Jolly good one.
Beautiful.
We love you. Are you staying safe in lockdown with your beautiful family?
I am indeed. We're all eating way too much, you know, how it goes in lockdown.
It doesn't count.
And I hope that you are safe too and that everyone is and that we can find some joy in the simple things while we're, you know, struggling to see everybody at the moment.
Exactly. And
thank
when
you,
this blasted coronavirus is done, we'd love to see you in our studio. We miss you.
I would love to come back. Thank you very much.
All right. See you,
take
soon.
Care.
Bye. In a moment. Is it all right?
Mm.
Yeah, good?
Mm.